This is an Emerson 26C38 series string color set from 1969. And this is the first time I'm running it. Things are unstable with it, the colors. And obviously, it's been sitting for several years.
Let's see what we see here. It is an instant on set. There's a switch in the front. The contrast, brightness, and vertical controls. The tuners. It's very simple in front.
The picture's washed out, really.
It uses some oddball tubes in it.
But I saved the set because, I mean, there's hardly any of these left. I mean, Emerson never had a good reputation. And this was kind of at the end of when National Union was building them. Now it uses a 25 AJP22 picture tube. The horizontal output is a 40 KG6. The damper is a 42 EC4. And there's six GH8As running the set. So let's come around, let's see. And of course all of the controls have been messed with. I mean, I had to play around with this thing for several minutes just to get the picture as good as it was. Let's pull the back off the tabletop here. See, it has a vertical chassis here, and the board in the bottom. Tuner assembly and all back here. 26C38 walnut, A17-9. Maybe some kind of date code. It's a Dumont picture tube, 25 AJP22. Can't read the EIA code on it. Oh, let's see, gotta get down lower. Is that resting? Like that. It's an EC4 from Holland. KB6, all of these tubes are made in Holland. Yep, Dumont branded tubes. Like most of the originals, made in Japan. Let's see. Let's take a look in the cage and see how the flyback looks. vehicle. You can see that there's a little bit of drippage in there. There's a GE rectifier tube in there. It just doesn't look like there's a whole lot to it for a color set, you know. It's a pretty compact chassis. EIA 274, and there's a 69-something date code on there. This set was a trade-in from the place I got it from. There's a sticker for a place called Bragg's TV Service. Of course, it says Emerson Television and Radio Company, Jersey City, a division of National Union Electric, and the original model tag there. But this is something that I'm gonna. Try to start playing with after I get a few other things out of the way. I finally brought home everything from storage and cleaned my storage space out, and this is just a small portion of what I had when I was able to fit in the room. This is the Cape Heart stereo I was working on years ago. There's the 65 Magnavox that I had to stop working on. This is a 68 Sylvania. It's a 66 RCA Consolette with black and white. This is a 69 Sylvania color remote set. And I've still got the original remote back here. And the paperwork still hanging on the back. There's a TG&Y TV Sampo. It's led a hard life, but still works perfect. And of course, there's the old Webcore, and this is a 59 Silvertone first stereo they made. I don't have the extension speaker for the stereo, but this thing, actually, I powered it up and played it for about 5 minutes, and it's got a great sound to it as is, but a resistor started burning up inside, so this is something I'm probably going to dig into pretty soon. This thing really sounded good. I'm really curious about it. The old Webcore here, something happened with the changer while it was in storage. It has some issues now. Something's jamming up. But yeah, for all you folks who've never seen one, probably one of the few survivors, a 69 Emerson color TV.